Article six. Motion reads, move that the town appropriate $2.9 million to pay the cost of designing and building a fire substation to be located on the town-owned lot known as the North Hadley Village Hall Ball Field, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto, and that to meet this appropriation, the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow said amount under and pursuant to Chapter 44, Section 3A of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the town, therefore, provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon the approval by the voters to exclude the amounts to pay for the bonds or notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of Proposition 2.5, so called. Any premium received by the town upon the sale of any bonds or notes approved by this vote, less any such premiums applied to the payment of the cost of insurance of such bonds or notes, may be applied to the payment of costs approved by this vote in accordance with Chapter 44, Section 20 of the General Laws, thereby reducing the amount authorized to be borrowed to pay such costs by a like amount. At this time, first motion. Second. Been moved and seconded. I would like to have Mr. John Michkowski, who is one of the petitioners, has a PowerPoint presentation. And we also will let Joyce Chungalo speak first. It isn't? Perfect. I'm sorry.
Good evening. Thank you, everybody, for coming out this evening. This select board is in the process of selling the North Hadley Village Hall. We have not come to any conclusion on that yet. A committee was set up to pursue putting a fire station up in North Hadley and keeping one there. We are keeping, we would like to keep a piece of that property or all of that property, as two other articles down the road will address the other issues if this one passes. The town is exploring ways of storing equipment and providing fire services in other locations also. An ad hoc committee was founded, and they will speak to this article also. We have a large area up there that we've always taken care of, and Hadley has grown and expanded to include many more areas and streets in North Hadley that need to be covered by fire protection. Our fire chief has done many studies through over the past couple of years on fire times in the center station going to North Hadley, and it would benefit most people up in that area if we continued to have a substation up there.
I'll call on Mr. Michkowski to answer any questions anybody might have after his presentation.
Good evening, everyone. I'm John Michkowski, chairman of the ad hoc committee. This is the North Hadley Fire Station as we're looking to replace it. And I'd like to introduce the members of this committee. First, John Michkowski, Sr. I'm the chairman. I'm a former firefighter and commander of the Hadley Aquatic Rescue Team and a business owner. Myron Chuzik is the past fire chief and a construction estimator. Howard Koski, an engineer and attorney. Franco Quadro, a building contractor and professional estimator. Willie Danlinko represents the Municipal Building Committee and the electrical inspector. Edward Dukevitz is a past deputy fire chief and civil defense director. And these are all voting members. The advisory was Donald Pipchinski, part of the select board, Michael Spanknebel, fire chief and emergency manager, management director, Mike Mason, police chief, and Marjorie Townsend, historical commission representative. The Hadley Select Board voted to support the public safety is a number one priority for the town based upon a recommendation made by the Municipal Building Committee. The Municipal Building Committee provided a draft of recommendations, of which the North Hadley Fire Substation was number one. The committee provided three options for review and analysis. Final recommendations to be provided after more in-depth study of the new building site options. The Hadley Municipal Building Committee draft recommendation, June 8, 2016. This is from the minutes of the building committee. Draft recommendation number one, type A, North Hadley Fire Substation. The committee all agreed that recommendation one is to locate a new accommodations for the fire apparatus currently in North Hadley. As it's commonly known, the town has voted to sell the North Hadley Hall Village Hall, including an existing undersized fire substation wing of the building. The committee unanimously supports a fire department present in North Hadley based on convincing testimony by the fire chief that such space is necessary to maintain existing fire response to the times in North Hadley. Number 1A is to construct a new bay at the center station was not recommended. Number 2 was building a new fire substation on a new site that last spring was denied overwhelmingly and voted down. And number 3, to build a new fire substation on the ball field adjacent to the North Hadley Hall. The ad hoc committee's task in May of 2016, actually it was June, the Hadley Select Board appointed the North Hadley Fire Substation Committee, the ad hoc committee, to research, gather information, and conduct a feasibility study on the current ball field site next to the North Hadley Hall as a potential site for a new fire substation. The new station will set out in the field between the North Hadley Hall and the church. The proposal North Hadley site is owned by the town of Hadley. The current site has been home of the North Hadley Fire Substation for 53 years. The cost of this new proposal is $2.9 million. It's reduced from $3.6 million. The square footage was first at 6,500 square feet, and now it sits at 5,200 square feet. The plot plan for this site puts in 13 parking spots towards the rear that would give access to the North Hadley Pond for Hadley residents. It would give 15 parking spots to the north boundary for the church so they would not have to park on the road in front of the station, and 5 parking lots behind for call firemen. And as you see in this plan, there's plenty of green around the building and between the station and the North Hadley Hall. Here we have the layout of the floor, which would have storage, proposed future bunk rooms, a generator room, mechanical room, electrical room. There would be 2 bathrooms in it, a kitchen, they got the bathrooms, the kitchen, and a backup communication center and meeting room. And to the right of this, there would be the apparatus that would hold 2 full engines, a possible future ambulance, and either a brush truck or mini pumper. I'd like to turn this over now to the fire chief for history about the North Hadley Fire Department.
Good evening, Mr. Moderator. Thank you for allowing me to speak tonight, Select Board, Finance Committee, and all the residents of Hadley. I was asked to be in an advisory role with myself and Chief Mason, and I'd also like to say thank you to the ad hoc committee that spent a lot of time, especially Mr. Mitrakowski, putting all this information together for you. And I was asked to put together a little history of the North Hadley Fire Department. So this is a photo of when they first finished it, and there's probably some folks in the station that donated time. One of them would be the electrical inspector, who was also on the ad hoc committee. And there's probably others here that were on the fire department that also, right in the front row here, that also helped out with that. So there was a study that was done, information from the North Hadley Village Hall Study Committee in 1989, and Miriam R. Pratt had put together a history, and I just took some parts of that for your information. So the North Hadley School and Hall was actually built in 1864 as a two-story school with a social hall above it. In 1871, an L was added to accommodate the over 100 children in 8 grades. Then in 1954, the building was closed as a school and was utilized as the North Hadley Branch Library and was the home to many social groups such as 4-H, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts. I believe there's still some of their stuff in the basement there. In 1963, the L portion was converted and became the North Hadley Firehouse after extensive renovations, as they needed to fill the center to accommodate the two heavy fire trucks that you saw in the picture prior. The hook and ladder number 5, which is the Volunteer Fire Department of North Hadley, which was first organized in 1908, was reactivated in 1962 to man that station. And they are still in service today and still attend all of our annual events that we have and Christmas events. So they also fitted out the rear room above the firehouse, and that's where our 911 receiver was for numerous years, and it was also a meeting space and an alternate operation center. These were taken last week, so this is the current state of the North Hadley Fire Station. You can see that it's pretty worn. Currently, the station is housing our Engine 2, which is a 1987 Pierce Arrow, which is slated for replacement by your generous vote to bring in a new rescue pumper, which will hopefully be here in the next 4 to 6 weeks. It also houses, at this time, our brush truck, Brush 1, which is a 1951 Dodge Power Wagon, and also an antique hose wagon that was donated by the West family to the Hadley Firemen's Association and the Hadley Fire Department, which is a very special piece that's parked in here as well. So it's very packed. These are just some additional photos, and we do have packets outside if you didn't get a chance to see them. It's also extremely tight in there, and we've been discussing how we're going to fit the engine that is at our center station up into this station without some modifications and moving some stuff around. You can see how there's not much room to get on or off the truck. Trucks aren't getting any smaller. Unfortunately, they're getting bigger with the amount of equipment that we need to carry on them. So it's quite tight. This is just the heating unit and then the small area that we have for storing our turnout gear for the firefighters. And then we have a very small bathroom with a nice slop sink for them to wash up after they come back from the fire. I'm going to turn it back over to Mr. Michikowski.
Where'd you do up my list of stuff?
There you go.
Okay. On May 3rd, the planning board voted 4-0, one absent, to endorse the concept of using the portion of the North Hadley Hall Fire Station on the site for the new substation. October 12, 2016, the select board voted 3 in favor, 2 against, with one change his vote, so it would be 4 in favor and one against for the proposed building on the location. October 17th, the Capital Planning Committee voted unanimous to support the North Hadley Fire Station on the proposed location. October 18th, the Municipal Building Committee voted unanimous to support the North Hadley Fire Substation on its proposed location. And October 18th, the Finance Committee voted unanimous to support the North Hadley Fire Substation on the proposed location. We received a letter from the past building inspector, and I'd like to read. He was a past building inspector, he was on a planning board, school committee, and a select board member and a veteran, Frank Zalot Jr. I'd like to read this letter. I served the town of Hadley as building inspector in the 1950s and 60s and in the mid-1980s in 1985. I was ordered by the Board of Selectmen to inspect all town buildings and to report my findings. I inspected the North Hadley Hall and filled out my report stating its physical condition. No part of the North Hadley Hall complied with the building code in place at that time. I listed the discrepancies in my report, and my recommendation was to dismantle the building and erect a new modern building to meet the growing demands of our town. This included a fire station, safety complex, etc. To repair the hall to bring it into compliance would be very difficult and very costly. My recommendations made me add aid and protect the people living in the northern section of Hadley. 30 years have gone by and still nothing has been done. I have served Hadley in the past as a building inspector, selectman, school committee, and postmaster. I have seen the town grow from a small farming community to where it is today. The needs of fire protection have grown with it. It is still my recommendation to replace the present building by erecting a modern building that will meet the needs of the northern needs of our northern community for many years to come. I want to add that I have enjoyed working with all the town. The town departments in the past, especially with the planning board for so many years. We all worked together to make Hadley a very special place to live in. Sincerely, Frank Zela Jr. Potential residents and commercial insurance impact. I contacted the insurance company for a test quote. What would it cost for insurance for evaluated house at $500,000, and in this report, this is what I'm going to read that if I can find it here. Only too many papers here. In their homeowner's manual, protection classified information. For jurisdiction listed with a single classification number, all properties within the jurisdiction should receive a listed classification number. For classification listed with multiple classification numbers, known as split classifications, the classification number applicable to individual properties is assigned as follows. For properties located 5 road miles or less from a recognized respondent fire station of a fire department indicated in the listed for the jurisdiction and within 1,000 feet of a recognized water source, that first listed numerical classification designer applies to 6 /6. For properties located 5 miles or less from a recognized respondent fire station of the fire department indicated in the listing of the jurisdiction with a recognized water source more than 1,000 feet, the second listing classification designer would be X or Y, applies to 6/6 or 6X or 6Y. So what they say here, number 6, because of the water flows and everything, would be the highest, 10 being the worst. So in that test quote, a house valued at $500,000, if the fire station was more than 5 road miles away from that house, they would expect an increase in their fire insurance for almost $600. And the fire chief is currently conducting a community review with ISO, that's Insurance Survey Office. All right, now I'll turn this back over to the fire chief.
Thank you. So not, just to clarify, not all insurance companies follow ISO, but ISO is a pretty extensive, they do a lot of research on the community, so that'll be a long process. And there is the potential for impacts on insurance costs. But then again, it depends on the insurance company that you have. So I was asked to put together my opinion as to why we need the North Hadley substation. So first of all, I'd like to just say thank you to the 10-plus firefighters that are out all over town right now dealing with power lines down, trees on top of cars, and trees actually falling down all around them. And they're working hard right now for all of you. And that's also along with the police department as well. And just so you know, the North Hadley substation allows for call force members who live north of Huntington Road. So before I became chief, this was all put together by past chief Myron Chudzik, deputy chief Ed DeKevitz, James Keitza, were all part of this, where anyone who lived north, they kind of cut the town in half at that point. So they did this in order that those folks that lived on that side of the line could respond to the station for apparatus and equipment. So it allows for a quicker response with an engine to a multitude of emergencies which the fire department handles in the North Hadley section of town, when the members are available. And I'll tell you, they're available quite often. The proposed station will provide our members with the facilities and equipment that they need and deserve to store their department turnout gear in a clean and safe structure, with the ability to wash and dry their equipment, and also to provide showering facilities so firefighters can properly decontaminate themselves following incidents so they are not bringing the hazards home to their families. The state fire marshal is currently doing massive outreach to all the fire chiefs and the fire departments, as there is a 1 in 3 incidence in my age group of firefighters that are coming down with some type of cancer. So it is our mission and our goal to make sure that all the new folks that come on board, including my son who is interested in joining the call force, aren't going to be exposed to that. And what that involves is having the ability for these gentlemen, when they get back from a call, to be able to take a shower, and the ability for them to throw their turnout gear into a washer and clean it. We currently have that at our center station, but I can tell you at 2 o'clock in the morning, after you've been fighting a fire for 2 hours and you can't feel your legs anymore, it's difficult to find the energy when there's another 15 people that also need to wash their turnout gear to be able to do that. So we want them to, at a minimum, be able to wash themselves and go home clean to their families. And I honestly and truly believe that that's due to them. The proposed structure provides for redundancy in communications and fire police operations in the event our main station becomes disabled. This past summer, we lost power at our center station, and fortunately, we do have a backup generator, but the main motherboard on it failed, so our station went completely black. Luckily, the power was restored quickly, but we had approximately 5 minutes left on our backup battery system that runs our dispatch center. After that, we would have been working off of just portable radios and trying to communicate with all of our responders that were out handling calls. It also put our 911 system, all those calls would have been transferred to East Hampton. So that's been fixed. We've increased the battery storage through some grant funding we received through the Mass Emergency Management Agency. We're going to be beefing up those backups, so we have a little bit more time. But this is one of the reasons why we're also looking for this north station. The proposed structure will provide for emergency management, sheltering supply storage, and an alternate emergency operations center as well. I don't know if you remember 2011 when we had the Snowtober incident, but at about this time, actually Halloween, we set up a warming station at the Hadley Elementary School because we were lucky enough to have power there. We actually held Halloween. Kids came out to trick or treat that year in that station. We were fortunate, however, that there was power at that site. So the proposed structure will be constructed with full backup emergency generated power to allow for a short-term emergency shelter, warming and cooling station in the event of a man-made or natural disaster. We all see how bad the weather's getting. The proposed structure has been designed with future town and department growth in mind, and the proposed structure provides for storage relief for both police and fire departments with the incorporation of a mezzanine level where we can put our records that we have to keep. Also, I think they did a very nice job with the proposed structure that will enhance the North Hadley Village and fit in with the local architecture. So the members of the Hadley Fire Department are split into two groups for station coverage. The North Station is staffed by members that live, oh, sorry about that. Currently, that station is covered by 8 members that live north of Huntington Road. One of them sitting in the back right now, the rest are out on calls. I also put together some information for you on the structures in North Hadley that are in the response area. There's approximately 970 plus structures that the North Hadley Station, that's just north of Huntington Road, protects. Approximately 681 of those are homes, actual residences. The mean home value in Hadley, according to the assessor's office, is $313,700. So a total home evaluation for that area, and we know that a lot of the homes in North Hadley are 500 plus, but the total home evaluation based upon that assessor's would be $213 million that we're protecting. There's many structures in the North Hadley response area. There's numerous farms with multiple outbuildings, propane tanks, fuel storage. We have architectural timber and millwork, the North Hadley Sugar Shack, the Five College Farm, which is now under the ownership of University of Massachusetts. It is now adding 3 portable classrooms that'll be up within the next month. Carl's Excavating and Site Work and River Drive Excavating are both heavy equipment, so there's a lot of equipment storage at those sites. We have 2 churches, Wesley United Methodist Church and the North Hadley Congregational Church. We have 3 residential assisted living facilities in that area. 2 of them are completely non-ambulatory, so we would be responding to them very quickly. One of them's right down the street from North Hadley Fire Station. And then we have numerous multifamily residences in that area as well. Finally, in 2015, our engine 2 went out the door or covered the North Station 123 times for the calls that we had. That's a monthly average of 10.25 calls. And this year, just through October 26th, that truck has already gone out 160 times, which averages 16 calls over the first 10 months of the year. And this is the last slide, I promise. Actually, one more. So if there is a call in North Hadley and any member of either the North Station or our center station is available, they can respond to that station. I put these photos up here because this is a perfect example where we had our past deputy chief and his son driving by the station, and this call came in for this. This is all the way up in North Hadley, and very heavy windy day, and those gentlemen jumped on the truck and were able to establish a water supply very quickly in order to protect not only the woods around it, but the multiple structures that surrounded it as well. So in conclusion, I was asked to put together some recommendations. So as the fire chief, I'm appointed by the Hadley Select Board, and under Mass General Law, Chapter 48, Section 42, it's my responsibility to provide to the town adequate fire protection for the protection of life and property, and to report to the Board of Selectmen from time to time on the condition and recommendations thereon relating to the department's operation. It is my professional recommendation, and I believe very much in line with the past fire chiefs who have held the position before me, that the North Hadley Fire Substation is a critical need and needed for the protection of all residents of Hadley. Those gentlemen respond all over Hadley, not just North Hadley. The visitors of Hadley and the businesses of Hadley. 2 of the gentlemen today, I wanted to say thank you. Firefighter Joseph Boisvert, Lieutenant Richie Blyda, Lieutenant Ricky Bermucci, and a number of other center station firefighters, and I thank them as well, responded to a motor vehicle accident this morning. Thank God they were all in town to help us with it. Gentleman drove off the road and was trapped. His legs were pinned. He was down a hill, very, very scary situation. Sergeant Cook was with us. He can attest to that. Those gentlemen showed up within minutes to get the fire trucks that we needed with our jaws of life in order to pull him out. So I appreciate your support on this. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to ask. I thank you for your time.
Thank you, Chief. Questions?
Gene Palmer, 16 Farm Lane. That took quite a while. Could we make a motion to run this question?
I'm not going to accept that at this time because I know some people might have more technical questions. Any other questions?
Shell Horowitz, 16 Barstow Lane. I see the selectmen voted 3-2 in favor. I would like to hear the arguments from the two who voted against.
There was 4-1. I think one changed.
That'd be me. That was me. I did change it. From the original scope of it, it was a bigger floor model, and I thought it needed to be a little smaller to adequately fit on the property. So it actually was a 4-1 vote. I originally was one of the two that voted against it. I changed my vote to voting for it.
Well, by process of elimination, that leaves me, so I'm the one that still was a dissenting vote. First of all, I want to say I've always been a very vocal supporter of enhancing the fire department and the services. You can go back and check the select board meetings for the past couple of years, and that very clearly has been a number one priority, public safety. My concern is that I'm afraid that the decision right now on this substation is a little bit short-sighted. So my reasoning behind that is, you know, we're talking about building for the future, but in the spirit of long-range planning, I think we need to determine exactly what that future will look like. And I think we've got a little bit of a cart in front of a horse here. The impetus behind moving forward quickly with the substation had to do with the presumed lack of storage at the existing facility because a new fire truck was arriving. And I think that, you know, we've talked about that in previous meetings. So that fire truck is on its way, and it needs to find a home. So the question was, is there any alternative that can be explored? And I think that there are some potential short-term solutions to that. So what's still unresolved in my mind, you know, we don't know whether the town's going to have an in-house ambulance service. That still hasn't been determined. We don't know if we're going to move to a full-time fire force, and if so, and I would argue we should, but when that might happen, how many years down the road that is, and what impact that might have on the design of the substation in North Hadley. I think the original fire study did support a North Hadley substation, but it did cite a lack of data. I think the fire chief has gone a long way in trying to provide us with better information, and I appreciate that. So really, you know, I think I've gotten over whether or not we need a substation in North Hadley. I think in all likelihood, you know, again, based on the recommendation of the chief, that we should continue with that. But I also worry about, is this the best location? If indeed we believe that we may have expansion plans in the future, that lot is very limited. And I know that, you know, it was mentioned that town meeting did vote against purchasing land in North Hadley at the annual town meeting, but that's because there was no real plan for it. It was just raw acreage, and we didn't come before you and say, this is what we're planning on using it for. And it was a $500,000 price tag for an awful lot of land, far more than we need for a substation. So my opinion is I would prefer that we defer the vote to the annual town meeting, fully flesh out a public safety plan, and then determine if this building is best suited to meet the needs. My worry is honestly about Central Station. I think that that's where we need to be paying the most attention. And again, have a fully thought out design for Central Station, and then make sure that the substation in North Hadley wraps around that. Instead, we're going the other direction. We're designing out the North Hadley substation. We haven't yet figured out exactly what we're going to do at Central Station. And I really don't want to be in front of you you know, in a couple of years, you know, rethinking this whole thing. I think it would be better for everybody if we just had one plan and we knew exactly what order we were going to do it in. So, again, you know, absolutely want to support our fire department, there's no question. But my opinion right now is I'd rather see the money spent on coming up with a fully fleshed out plan and make sure we have the manpower.
Mr. Moskin.
Dave Moskin, 83 Rocky Hill Road. I guess I'm going to address Chief Spanknebel. Chief, there was that fire study that Molly just referred to, and I wanted to ask you, Mike, there were a lot of recommendations in that rather comprehensive study. Would going ahead with this new substation in any way slow down the other priorities that they had in front of substation? And the other part of the question is, the town's had trouble maintaining their buildings, as we know as we go around town. I don't know what the cost would be on an annual or monthly basis of a new substation, but it'd be sad to see a new station deteriorate the way our buildings seem to deteriorate. So I was curious about the annual operating or upkeep cost of a new substation, and if we can handle it.
As far as the annual costs, I really can't answer to that. This is a concept. The drawings are a concept. This building was scaled down because the police chief and I originally, the 100-foot by 65-foot proposal included a Hadley Police substation as well. We didn't feel that that was necessary. So we rescaled this. This is expandable as it is. So as far as the fire department's study that was done in 2012, I believe, we are currently chipping away at that very large list. So the question is, I've been asked many a times, what's the priority of the fire department? Is it staffing or is it the North Hadley station? And in my professional recommendation, I don't know if everyone here, I know there's a lot of people who understand that in order to have a full complement just to get out the door on our truck, we're supposed to have four firefighters. That's under NFPA standard. There's supposed to be two gentlemen and ladies that can go into the building for a search and rescue, and then there's supposed to be two that can go in after them if they're not able to get themselves back out. So that would be a minimum of four firefighters, 24/7, 7 days a week. And that's if it's a very small fire. We will always, in Hadley, need a call force. The town of Amherst has a call force department and also has a student force where they utilize UMass students. That's part of my goals and objectives to research if that's an option for us. As of right now, we don't have the staffing. It's myself and one full-time fire prevention lieutenant. And I can tell you that we are going out the door all the time. I know there's been questions about what we're responding to. We're responding to motor vehicle accidents. We're responding to structure fires. We're responding to folks lost in the woods, like today, a 10-year-old boy at Hartsbrook School decided to wander off. So in coordination with the police department, we set up a command structure and with the state police started searching for a 10-year-old boy. And luckily we found him very quickly. So we do mountain rescues. We protect Skinner State Mountain Park with major brush fires that happen usually every 10 to 15 years. We can't do it without a call force department. My opinion is that station is designed to be able to grow. It's big enough that if the town does decide to fund a full-time fire department, which I'm hoping that they will soon, that as we grow into that, because I know it's going to have to be done in phases, that we're still going to need those call force gentlemen and ladies to go to that station to get equipment and to back us up. I've been asked about, can we just have Sunderland, can we just have Amherst, can we just have Northampton come and take care of these calls? Mutual aid, which we have signed, we have mutual aid agreements, that is designed, just as in the police department, for worst case scenario, when all your assets are taken up and you don't have anything else. For example, this morning, we had Northampton with four firefighters and Amherst with two engines at that car accident. We probably had 14 firefighters working on that car to try and get that gentleman out of the car. So we're utilizing mutual aid. However, the town of Amherst, you can see it on Facebook, how overwhelmed they are with the number of ambulance calls. And Northampton, luckily, they're staffed with between 13 to 17 firefighters a day, which is based upon what they're bringing in revenue from their ambulance service. And that's what we're looking into now as well, being able to support staffing with ambulance receipts. And that's where we're going into a study on that next as well. So as far as I'm concerned, hopefully that answered your question. My opinion is that North Station is critical. And I think that we scaled it in a way that is expandable and we'll be able to handle future growth.
Thank you, Chief. Ma'am?
Bianca Epstein, 77 Hockenham Road. I guess I have a couple of questions. The first one is, are we voting tonight on that floor plan and that that's out in the hallway? Is that what we're actually voting on?
Yes.
Okay.
That's a proposal.
Okay, that's your proposal. I actually appreciated the one dissenting voter who talked about deferring the vote till a later time until we really assess our needs more completely. And so the second question I have is, Is the reason the storage is so tight in that North Hadley facility because there are those antique trucks being stored in there? I mean, does that have anything to do with the lack of space?
No, it's just not a very big space. I mean, that's built, that building's very old and it hasn't been renovated. And like the chief said, you know, every time we replace a fire truck and we get rid of the oldest ones, the new ones we're getting are bigger. And so it just, you're running out of room in that building, basically.
And then I have an opinion about, I guess I would say I'm not in favor of the parking lot part of the proposal because my guess is that there'll be a runoff into Lake Warner, which already has a lot of runoff, and I'd rather not see that land just be taken up with a parking lot. And that could save expenses as well.
That's not going to happen because all buildings today have to comply with MS4. All the runoff off the roof, off the parking lot, have to be dispensed within its area, not in the North Hadley Pond, not on a neighbor's lawn, or nowhere else, but on site. And this station will always be a substation, and it's very vital. It's been there for 53 years. It's there for protection of life and property. The people in North Hadley deserve it. They paid taxes for this protection. They deserve this protection. We're doing this for you people. And it's a backup. Also, this group, they back up the center station. The center station needs work, but this whole town needs work. We do one thing at a time. And I would urge you folks to vote and support the fire department. They're there for you. You have to be there for them. Thank you.
John Edwards, 3 Hawk Meadow Drive. I just had a question about the field itself. Is there a dollar figure for the replacement of that field, or is there a plan to replace the field, or has that been considered in the costing of the construction?
That's all part of the construction cost.
Shell Horowitz, 16 Barstow Lane. I very much support the idea of having a substation in North Hadley, but I think we might be premature after listening to Selectwoman Keegan and some of the audience comments. And it seems like I'm not feeling such an urgency that we have to get this done on an emergency basis without really thinking it through. And I would like to know, Brian, what the appropriate motion is to bring this back in the spring for further study. I don't know. I don't think we table it. I just don't know the legal form of the motion I'd like to make.
Well, let's try the facts. The new truck is coming in. They have no place to park it. Now, you can't take these trucks and park them out in the street. So you need a place to house them. They had an estimate cost of $50,000 a year for rental to store them. So to me, that's just throwing money away. That still does not solve the problem.
I would still like to hear how I'm supposed to make this motion.
I mean, there's a bunch of different things. You can vote it down.
I don't want to vote it down. I want to bring it back in the spring when we've had more time to think about it.
Well, then, I don't need no more time.
You don't, huh?
I don't need no more time thinking.
You can table it. You can pass over it. You can make.
Okay, I move that we pass it over.
Second.
This is your second time speaking, so you're going to have to move to the back of the line. We have some concerned citizens that want to speak to the article.
I've said my.
Yeah. I, Catherine Kentfield for Breckenridge. I have a couple of questions. I'd also like to comment on the earlier gentleman's statement, but I know that may be out of turn. My first question is whether Article 6 necessarily binds the new fire substation to that site, because the way it's stated in the warrant doesn't mention that.
The updated warrant, it does state that it is on that location.
Okay.
It's in the motion.
Okay.
So that takes care of that. What was your second question?
I'd like to just state that I'm very much in favor of a substation in North Hadley, but I'd like to ask the fire chief, I'm not sure if it's appropriate to ask him this question, but if his opinion on that site in particular, not about whether we need a fire substation, but about that site.
When this whole process started with the decision to sell North Hadley Fire Station, I worked closely with the Municipal Building Committee as well. And again, it seems to me that it's a pretty reasonable option that you're looking at a space that the town of Hadley already owns. So you're not gonna have to look at trying to find another piece of property. The initial estimate that came in from that, although it was a big piece of property, was $500,000 for the site to build on it. Am I opposed to looking to other sites? Absolutely not. However, it seems that we have this space available to us now, and basically what we're doing, so people aren't concerned, we are not going to be parking trucks outside. I want to make that clear. We are looking at storage options. We've been working with the town administrator to try and come up with different locations that we could actually work out of if we have to move out of North Hadley's out of North Hadley Station. We also have in capital some funding in order that we can do some minor repairs in order that we have the height that we need and be able to move stuff around. And yes, the storage that we have is limited at the center station as well. We are tapped out on space. So as far as I'm concerned, do I think this is a viable option? Absolutely. But I'm not opposed to looking at other sites.
I also like to add the selectmen did send the RFP out looking for land for a new fire station. Absolutely no responses.
My name is John Allen, 111 Middle Street. I'm not opposed to the substation per se, but in preparation for this meeting, several of us who are former selectmen and former finance committee have met with Chief Spangnable over coffee. And one of the things we asked him was, what is his first priority? And I'm pretty sure all of us heard him say that his first priority is manpower. That makes sense to me, because the issue here is that as the fire study that's been referred to several times here tonight says, that call fire departments these days don't work as well as they used to. And the reason they don't is that people don't work in the town where they live as much as they used to in the old days. That means, and Chief Spangnable, I totally sympathetic with his problem, is he has a hard time staffing the fire department with the four people that he needs on the fire truck during the day. So our first priority, and it's mentioned by the study, is to work somehow to get a full-time fire department during the day and hope the town can be covered at night by people who want to be in the volunteer fire department, work out of town, but are back here at night. So I would like to, not opposed to the substation, but I would like to have a plan that works for the town, that shows the town where we're going. Are we going to have a full-time fire department during the day? Are we going to have a substation? You know, let's have a plan that is more than just these ad hoc decisions that we seem to be making. We have several articles on this warrant about the substation alone, and some of them are contradictory. Let's have a plan. Thank you.
Mr. Pipchinski would like to respond to the last question.
Our fire chief has worked many months and many man hours for a safer grant in this town, which would have been a federal grant, bringing four firefighters into our department, which would have been compensated by the grant. 1 week ago, we heard we were denied. And the reason why they denied us, we're too rich of a community.
Gene Baxter, 35 Stockwell Road, North Hadley. I'm very familiar with this site. I am in favor of building this building at this time with this money. I was Sunday school teacher for North Hadley Church, very active there for probably 2 decades. And I've taught kids on the field. People were concerned about the field. I'm a little bit sad about the field. But I'm also very excited about the parking. I've been a member of the church. As we park along Route 47 on snowy mornings with half of our rear ends way out in the middle of the road, having the 13 or 15 parking spaces along the fence is going to be terrific. I think this is the right building at the right time in the right place. And we've certainly been talking about it for years. I don't think this is ad hoc. I think this has just finally come to its time. Let's vote for it, and let's vote soon.
Thank you.
Jonah Berger, 21 Norwalk Drive. I just wanted to talk about the fire truck we're about to get again real quick. I know we talked about it a lot, but it sounds to me like if we push this off like some people want to until the May town meeting, we're paying for at least 7 more months of storage. And we're talking about a 6-figure approval that we're going to have to do in order to store that truck for that amount of time. Is that correct?
I don't know what the chief's exact plan is, but there will be movement, because when the new truck comes, that truck, chief, is probably going to be in center station, and then one of the other ones is going up north, right? So if we don't build a new substation, they are going to have to deal with that problem of storing those trucks up there. Do you have an exact plan?
So the one option was the one I explained, where we're going to try and modify the station if it doesn't need to be sold. So that was one option in order that we can get our engine 3, which is slated to move up there. The second option is the hose wagon I was telling you about, the 1926 REO speed wagon that we have at our center station. We've been working with the Hampshire Mall that has been very generous and has donated space to us to store some of our emergency management supplies that we'd like to move into a new north station. They're willing to allow us to park some of that equipment inside the mall, which is sprinklered. The fuel will be taken out, obviously, to try and alleviate some of the storage issues that we have at our center station. So short term, there was a proposal that was brought forward. I don't know if David, if you want to bring that up. In North Hadley, there was a rental option, and David can give you more information on that, but that is another option that we have.
So all I can say right now is that we're in negotiations for a price for rental space in North Hadley. It's not 6 figures.
Peter Mullady, 144 Mount Warner Road. It's the right building and it's the right time. I think the ball field is the wrong place. It's green space. One of the few pieces of green space we have there. I think losing it would be a tragedy. I just heard Chief talk about some options that I have not heard before. I just feel that there are other options to be looked at. Wisdom is the ability to discover alternatives, and I don't think we've discovered all the alternatives. Thank you.
Can you hold off? Ed, you haven't spoke to this yet. No, she spoke already once, so.
Hi. My name is Ed Ditkevitz. I've been on the Hadley Fire Department for 43 years. I retired last year as the assistant fire chief. And my opinion is, let's stop kicking a can down the road. We need that station because originally they put that in to cut down the response times to the center station to better serve the population of North Hadley. And I'm looking at life safety, where 5 minutes is a lot. That means whether you live or die, you come right down to it. And also, if you have a natural disaster in North Hadley, where do you put the people? The people have no place to go. There's no place over in North Hadley that has emergency power, which this does. And This station is built for the future. It's not built for today, like the old fire station was. The old fire station was, let's hurry up, get something done. You know, and if, I don't like buildings that need to be standing after there's been an after disaster to be built out of sticks. Now, they put a lot of time and effort into looking at this, and we've been talking about full-time firemen. Well, what's your response time going to be if your ambulance is out and you're sending two guys out on an ambulance, you're left with two guys? And if they have another call on, say, like in Hockenum, what happens in North Hadley? You're always going to need a call department. But then the cost-wise right now, our bond rating is good. You know, our debt load, and people looked at our debt load as it's going down. So now, now is the time to borrow. And it's a central location. It suits our needs well. It's on a major route. And that any space we put this on is going to be a green space. So it's my opinion that we should act on this today, not kick the can down the road, not wait for the springtime, and then we'll postpone it again and again and again. Let's get it done. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Randall Brockhurst. I live at 11 Mount Warner. I feel the fire station should remain where it is. If they have to build a new building, it's well worth it. Because if they move somewhere else, they're going to have to pay for the land, and it's going to cost them a bit more than if we stay where we are. Because a lot of people don't like different buildings, fire stations or police stations in their neighborhood, and the people are very well pleased in Northampton. I mean, not Northampton, but North Hadley, where it is, and I hope they keep it there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Catherine Kenfield, Fort Breckenridge. I absolutely support a fire substation in North Hadley. There's no doubt we need one. I do feel that the green space there is very important. I feel that that's not the right place for it. I also want to point out that passing this evening will not solve the storage issue for the new truck coming in 6 weeks. Is it possible for me to second the motion that the gentleman offered?
I'm going to let him make that motion after Edwin speaks. So, Shell, please stand behind.
Okay. Thank you.
Edwin.
Edwin Matuska, 116 Stockbridge Street. I picked up an agenda Monday, so obviously it might be obsolete already. But Article 6 is just giving the town permission to borrow the money to build a substation. Is that correct?
The motion was, I have to go back, move that the town appropriate for design costs in building. So that would be to design it and build it.
But not just, we're just giving permission for the town to design it and build it.
Yes.
But at that site?
Yes. Yes, that's the
difference. So what's the purpose of Article 8?
If this passes, I believe Article 8 is going to pass over.
Uh-huh.
And the reason why it's not in your warrant is because the updated warrant has specific language to that being on the ball field, not being just, the original one didn't specify the location. It could have been built anywhere.
Okay, is that correct? I guess what I'm trying to get at is if something happens to North Hadley Hall, then we have to build it on the ball field. Is that correct?
That's in the motion. That's the motion.
So if whatever happens to North Hadley Hall, you can't build it over there.
Right.
It has to be built on the existing ball field, what it is right now.
That's the motion.
Okay.
Motion is specific to the location.
Where is that printed motion available? Because I got this off the back table and it doesn't say it on here.
There's What's that?
Doesn't it have to be printed? No. Okay.
Yeah. Hold on. Town Council, Joel Bard.
Good evening, Mr. Moderator. Joel Bard, Town Council. There's some confusion here, and it's understandable. So there is a warrant, and you all have the warrant, and once it's posted, the warrant is not changed. The confusion here is that the motion was slightly different in its wording from what's in the article. So when you get a warrant, the concept, the idea behind a warrant is that it gives everybody warning of the topic to be discussed. So the topic to be discussed was a fire station in North Hadley for a certain amount. The motion, and so when the moderator reads the motion, when he introduces each new article, he's reading the specific motion that's going to be made. And so there are sometimes differences in wording. So in this event, the motion itself said, and the moderator read the first line, to pay costs of designing and building a fire station to be located on the town-owned lot known as North Hadley Village Ball Field. So that was the motion, and that's not typically handed out, but again, it was pointed out that there was a difference in language, and it's been pointed out earlier this evening where there have been other slight differences in some of the capital items. So the warrant that you have doesn't change, it's just the motion as it's made under certain articles might be slightly different from what you see in the printed warrant.
Mr. Moderator, Bob LaPrade, 16 Hadley Place. First of all, I'd like to commend the committee for the hard work that they did, and I feel for them, having heard the comments, that this is an ad hoc decision. Given the credentials that I saw in the presentation, I think that there was a lot of expertise behind putting this recommendation together, and I really feel that the town should embrace that and vote this in tonight.
Michelle Morris Friedman, 45 Roosevelt Street. Two very quick questions. One is, how will this possibly affect the sellability of North Hadley Hall? I don't know if you're already in negotiations with somebody to possibly buy the property. And the second question, is there anybody from Parks and Rec who has an opinion about whether that ball field should be kept as a ball field or become the fire station?
I don't think there's any update on the sale in North Hadley. That ball field hasn't been used in quite a few years. I don't think there's an update on the actual sale. Is there, David?
So as you know, the town meeting passed a resolution authorizing the select board to sell the North Hadley Village Hall. We went out to bid. We received two bids. One was accepted, and the proposer went to the Zoning Board of Appeals with a plan. That plan was not accepted, but the proposer still has an offer on the table for the selectmen to enact, if they so choose, to sell that property, and that would be for the entire property. So that's something that the select board are going to have to work through in the next couple of weeks.
As was pointed out earlier, even if we vote this in tonight, we still have to address the issue of where the new fire truck will fit. So therefore, I don't see why we have to get this done tonight, because it's not going to change that immediate aspect. And therefore, I will once again move that we pass this over until the spring town meeting.
I have a motion and a second. Do you have that in writing? Please. While he's writing that up, the current motion is to pass over. Is there any debate on that front?
One second.
Go ahead, Ed.
I'm speaking for the motion to pass over.
pass over the article? Yeah.
Go ahead.
Let's not kick the can down the road. Let's face the problem. And let's hold on. I urge you people
not to pass over this article. Because who knows what the interest rates are going to be from monetary-wise, and that this new truck is going to go in the new station, not the North Hadley station. There's been a lot of thought, a lot of effort put into this new station design by people who are building professionals, who have built buildings, and know how they're put together. So I would urge you to not pass this over, because it seems like from my experience in the past that it gets passed over, and over and over, and the problem does not get resolved. Let's resolve the problem tonight. Thank you.
Terry Yushko, 233 River Drive. I have two things. I would like not to see this passed over and it voted on tonight. The other thing is I'd like to ask David Nixon, how much is the offer on the North Hadley property? Which is $100,000. You're willing to sell a building lot with a building for $100,000 that gives the town the access to the property there. If you sell that property, the town then loses the access to the lake. In my opinion, I would rather see a town fire station there that can help the community and also keep the access to the lake.
Dan Ditkevitz, 130 Hockham Road. I remember one time when I was on the select board, I went down and I checked out this old fire station. And I got to tell you, I wouldn't keep a damn chicken in that place, okay? It is so bad. It's disgusting. I think one time they even lost, they had to come in there and fix the radiators because I think they froze, okay? They had problems in there. They had pipes burst, everything. You got to get something different, okay? It's just not working. Thank you.
It's been brought up numerous times, what are we going to do with this new fire truck when it arrives in 4 to 6 weeks? The chief has investigated the situation completely, and it's possible to renovate North Hadley Hall, where they are now, for less than $6,000. And that'll take care of it until we decide what happens to North Hadley Hall.
Thing that you need to remember is all of this can pass tonight. All you have to do is pass everything, then you go to the polls and you vote for what you want. So, you know, all of this is like, yes, we can argue here all night long, but guess what? We have the right to pass everything here tonight and move things forward. And then when you go to the polls, that's where it counts.
Joyce West, 219 Bay Road. We have been having studies that we have the bookshelves falling, studies. 2012, we had a study done, and someone says, I don't think this is the time. Well, let me tell you, we have petitions coming in because the select board are not moving forward on stuff. Sit it on a shelf. This town has got to do something for the town. North Hadley Hall is a disgrace. What, are you going to wiggle in there? I think it's time you did something. If you live in North Hadley, you better have fire protection there. Please, do not pass this over. Thank you.
Susan Garrett, 5 Lariana Lane. I'd just like to say that, you know, we can talk about, well, we don't have to immediately pass this. Well, maybe if you had to work in that area, if you were a firefighter and you had to actually be in that building, maybe you would feel that another few months is too long. Maybe if your life is in danger because people can't respond to the fire, you might think that actually waiting, kicking this forward is too long. So I urge everyone to pass this today.
Hi, I'm Dina Friedman, 16 Barstow Lane. I just want to first say that I really appreciate the job the firefighters do. And I have a question about the article that's coming up about demolishing North Hadley Hall, which...
We're not on that article.
We're not talking about that?
Right.
No, let me just... If we voted to demolish North Hadley Hall, which we may or may not do, conceivably, would it be possible to put the fire station there and keep the green space, and we'd still have the Goods fire station? It just seems like this might be out of order in terms of how we're voting for these things.
Right now, we are discussing the amended motion that Shell Horowitz made to pass over the question. We're not gonna talk about articles that are later on in the agenda, or we're gonna be here until about 2 o'clock.
No, I'm talking about the location of the fire station. I apologize if I was supposed to talk about passing over. I mean, I just don't think we'll talk about
Shell it. Made a motion to pass over, and that's what we're discussing right now. Ma'am, do you have any new information?
I just want to move the previous question.
Great. Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a motion to move and a second. So at this time, we are voting on the motion to pass over. Yes, we have to vote on wanting to move the question. So if you're in favor of moving the question and ending the discussion, raise your red card. Opposed? That's unanimous. So now...
Wait a minute. No. That was to vote.
Nearly. Close enough. Now we are going to vote on Shell's motion to pass over Article 6. All in favor of passing over Article 6, raise your red card. All who are opposed of passing over, signal with your red. I estimate that at 250. Motion fails. So now we revert back to the original motion.
I'd like to move the question on the original motion.
Well, it's been moved and seconded. Now we must vote on moving the question. All in favor of moving the original motion, signal with your red card. Thank you. Opposed? Opposed. 1, 2, 3. 279-3. Okay, now we will vote on the actual motion. Yes, I would. The motion reads, move that the town appropriate $2.9 million to pay the cost of designing and building a fire station to be located on the town-owned lot known as the North Hadley Village Ball Field, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto, and to meet this appropriation, the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow said amount under and pursuant to Chapter 44, Section 7.3 of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the town, therefore, provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon the approval by voters to exclude the amounts to pay for the bonds or notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of Proposition 2.5, so called. Any premium received by the town upon the sale of any bonds or notes approved by this vote, less any such premium applied to the payments of the cost of the insurance of such bonds or notes, may be applied to the payment of costs approved by this vote in accordance with Chapter 44, Section 20 of the General Laws, thereby reducing the amount authorized to be borrowed to pay such costs like a like amount. All in favor of the motion for Article 6, please signify with your red card. Mm-hmm. This will require a 2/3 vote.
Thank you. All opposed? Opposed. Any abstentions? One. You got to hold it up high, Ro. Be proud. Four abstentions. Five abstentions. So let me do my quick math here. Article passes.
I'd like to thank everybody for their support. We put an awful lot of time in it, but the job is not done. Thank you very much.